Hello, Drums Alive instructors. My name is Catherine Farfan Salim, and I am coming to you from Orlando, Florida. Today, we're going to learn a really fun routine to These Boots Are Made for Walkin'. Now, there are a lot of different variations to this particular song, but I know that you're gonna find the one we're using today is super fun. I'm going to do the routine with you, so follow along, and then we're gonna have a breakdown, and then do it together all over again. Here we go.
Are you ready, Boots? Start walking.
Walk-in. And like I mentioned before, there are several different versions of this song, so you have to use what works for your audience, for your members in your class. So what we're going to do first is break down each section for you. Now, the notes for this routine will be available, so you can take what you're learning right now and refer to those notes. So let's put these out to the side and go over some of the different sections of the song. So the very beginning, there is a little bit of a boom, 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 right? So we're gonna lift those heels up. We're in our regular beginning position of Drums Alive, right? In a little bit of a squat position, and I'm going to heel, 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 heel. So my heels are going around, my hips are going around, and I'm gonna take those arms around too. And I can go from one side to the other, right? Or just one side. All right, so that's boom, 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 boom. She says, are you ready, Boots? Start walking. Okay, that's what I love about this song. She's kind of letting you know what's going to happen. So for the next instrumental part, we're gonna just do pony hops. All right, so you can go one, two, three to each side. All right, or you can do a step tap, whatever works for your members, right? Whatever's working for your class. So we start da 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 bum ba da 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 bum. That's the part I'm talking about. Okay? And you can really get into it with your students on that. Okay, you're getting everybody ready for the verse, which is the next piece. So next piece is verse. If you're starting on your, you want your members to start on your right, you're gonna start on your left. Exactly. So we're gonna take our sticks and our leg and move over, okay? So that we're starting on the right. So we go 4, 3, 2, 1. Here, we're gonna go forward, back, all right? Then we go to the other side. 4, 3, 2, 1, forward, back, all right? Same thing happens even if you're stationary. So 4, 3, 2, 1. You can give it maybe more shoulders if you don't want to do the hop. And 4, 3, 2, 1, and forward, back, okay? That's your verse. So every time that she's singing along, right, in the verse part, those are the steps that you're going to do. And then, so let's go over some of the verses. So we have, you keep saying you've got something for me, right? So it's, you keep saying you've got something for me. Uh-huh. Something you call love but confess. Uh-huh. See how it works? And then we go, you've been a messin' where you shouldn't have been messin'. Good. Da, 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 da. And now someone else is getting all your boom. Bada. Now, chorus. So simple. Next part, which you know this, you know the words already. These boots are made for walking, right? So we're going to tap our heel with our drumstick, and the opposite arm is kind of just going to balance us. So it can be out here, it could be on the side, wherever you want it. And we're going to do 1, 2, down, 1, 2, down. So these boots are made for walking. And that's just what they'll do. One of these days, these boots are gonna walk all over you. So if you saw, I really brought the drumsticks down to let the audience know something's gonna happen. And guess what's gonna happen? You know already. The boom, 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 boom part. That's it. So in your notes, it's called a break. It's a little bit of a sassy break in there. And then we go to what? Yes, pony hop. So we go back to the instrumental. Da 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 dum bum ba da da dum bum ba da da dum. But this time it's shorter than the first time. It's only 2 counts of 8. All right? And then you go back to your verse. So you already know what's coming. Get yourself into position. And next part is you keep lying, blah, 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 and forward, back. You keep losing, right? And to the front, back. You keep saying, and then forward, back, what's right is right. And then forward, back. Chorus, these boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. One of these days, these boots are gonna walk all over you. Boom, 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 right? And then she goes into instrumental again. So what's your instrumental? Pony hop, okay? And you can, whatever arms come to you naturally here on your pony hop, right? You can even go up, down, whatever you wanna do here on the pony hop, All right, then you go back to the verse, which you know is here, right? Four of these, forward, back, forward, back. Okay, now, let's talk about this forward, back for a second. In your notes, you're gonna see one, two, three, one, two, three. You can do that, or you can just do tap, 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 tap. Whatever comes to you naturally, right? This is just a guide for you, guide of steps for you to use for this routine, but if something doesn't feel right, doesn't feel natural to you, go ahead and change it. That's the beauty of choreography. All right, and then you go back to your chorus. You go back to your chorus and then you go into the break. Boom, 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 boom. And then she says, start walking again, and you can just go back to your pony hop. Now, the pony hop, you can keep it here, facing your students, or you can turn halfway and come back to center, halfway, come back to center. If you noticed when I did it with you, I did it moving forward, moving back, turning around, moving forward and back, okay? Sometimes even in class, I'll come out behind the ball, right? And I'll just go in front of maybe one of the students and rock it out, okay? So you really want to engage with them on this because most of your students recognize this song, all right? So you wanna get them going and you wanna get them excited about the song, even if they don't know the words. But you need to know the words so you know what's coming up, all right? Now that you've learned the routine, we're going to try it again with the music. This time, I'm going to give you some cues that you can share along in your classes with your members. It's going to help them know what's coming up next.
Are you ready, Boots? Start walking.
Here we go. Walk it out. Up. Keep it going.
Nobody.
So now you've learned the different sections of the song, we did it together, and you're ready to go and do it in front of your class. So here are a couple of tips that you kind of just want to keep in the back of your head before actually taking it to your class. The first one is awareness of space. So you want to make sure that your students are realizing that we are using every side of the ball in this particular routine, with the exception of the front, right? So when we're stepping over to do our verse step, notice my placement. I'm in the middle of the two balls, okay? So if when you're demonstrating this particular movement, if you stay behind your ball, they're gonna do the same thing. So just be mindful that you're taking the step large enough so that you're in between both balls. You come back behind your ball, do your thing here, and then same thing on the other side, okay? So that's the first one. So them becoming aware of their space. So this way, as they move to the side, the next person is moving over as well. Okay, next thing is balance. Okay, so if you notice this particular movement here for these boots, this is a balanced movement. Okay, so that's why we don't have too much drumming going on, because I want to make sure that my students aren't going to fall over. Even those that have great balance, even for yourself, right? So if you want, you just bring it here, bring the hands down, bring the sticks down onto your ball. Or, I mean, once they've got it, you can definitely modify it, make it higher, whatever it is that you want to do there, okay? But it is, I specifically put that in the choreography as a balance movement, okay? To kind of calm it down from the craziness of our pony hops, all right? Next thing is, how do we modify this for all the participants in the class? So for me personally, I have classes where it's just in their chair. I have classes where they're in the chair and they stand up. So I offer a lot of different variety, and that's what the participants like to do. So what you can do is, while they're in the chair, you're going to keep the foot movements nice and simple. So maybe as they're reaching over, maybe they can just tap out with their leg on the side. Or they can keep their feet right where they are, forward, back. So you want to encourage them to give you more upper body movement, right? Especially if they're not moving the leg. And same thing here. Really give it. Everybody wants to rock it out like Nancy Sinatra, right? So we want to bring that up. We want to encourage them to give you as much body movement as possible. If you can then bring them up, same thing. They don't have to move their legs. They can do it right behind the ball like I am too. All right, so maybe that's where you progress to. You go from the chair, and then maybe a month from them, you have them move up to just standing. Okay, so you do what works, how they need to have it modified for your group. Now, what about you? You're the instructor, so you're gonna have to listen to this song a bazillion times, especially if you haven't heard it in a while. It always helps for you to just keep listening to the song so that you know all of the breaks, you know all of those little things, those that happen in between, so that you can really rock it out with your students. So remember, always listen to your song, even if you know it. Every time, I promise you, you're gonna hear something just a little different in there, and it's gonna help your classes be more successful. And last but not least, have fun. That is the main thing. So every time that I did the routine, I'm smiling, I'm encouraging you to rock it out, I'm thinking about the lyrics of the song so that I can engage you into what's happening, into that moment. Because we really want them to feel like their boots are just rocking it out. They're upset at this person and they're like, huh, these boots, you're gonna be walking it out soon. So you want to really rock it out with them and just have fun. And if you mess up, it's okay, because you know what? They don't know. So just as long as you keep that smile going and you can just walk it out with them and be like, yeah, rock it out, they'll love you for it. So those are my tips. I hope everything was helpful to you. I hope that you practice, and take this routine into your classes as soon as possible. They're gonna love it. Thanks so much.